In the Center for Alzheimer's Disease Research here at Brown, we're always looking for and really keenly interested in discovery, moving those discoveries into cures and treatments, and then ensuring that we have good public outreach. I feel that as researchers, they think it's so incredibly important that information gets to healthcare providers, you know, the people that individuals are seeing all the time, to be able to get the word out.
We know now that lifestyle effects have a kind of a big effect. So smoking, poor diet, lack of exercise, lack of cognitive stimulation. Vascular risk factors are also Alzheimer's risk factors. So high cholesterol, high blood pressure predispose people to develop Alzheimer's disease and dementia as well.
Of course, if one has several of those, then that's going to compound contributing to increasing the likelihood of developing Alzheimer's later in life.
One thing I just want to say about these lifestyle risk factors is that they are modifiable. You can improve them. And the kind of estimates from statistical models we have is that about 35% of the risk of Alzheimer's disease is modifiable. I mean, that's something we all should be capitalizing upon. Really, exercise, dietary changes, mental stimulation, these really can have an effect. And those are all under our control. You know, part of the power of all of these is preventative. And so if people can integrate these into their lives early, they're going to get more out of them.